Hi, I'm Tashi.
And I'm Devin.
We're here with another material science mission to look at something very mysterious. In bubbles!
See all those colors? Those shiny, shifting colors? Where do bubbles get them?
I'll give you a hint. It has to do with the very wobbly structure of a soap bubble and the way it plays with light.
For this experiment, you'll need tap water, corn syrup, dish soap, a flashlight, a bowl to mix everything, and small flat plate to blow bubbles on.
Mix up your bubble ingredients with a little bit of corn syrup so the bubbles don't pop as easily, and pour the bubble mixture onto the plate.
Now you take a straw, stick it into the solution, and blow. There! Beautiful. Look at my beautiful bubble.
Yeah, okay, it's beautiful. Congratulations. Now let's turn off the lights. Ooh.
And turn on the flashlights.
Very funny. Shine it on the bubble. Whoa, look at all those colors.
Why is this happening? How do we see those colors?
Light is the visible part of the electromagnetic spectrum, and that light contains all the colors of the rainbow. Here's the usual way we see color. I'm wearing a yellow t-shirt. The light that bounces off is the color that we see. My shirt is yellow because there is dye in the cloth that reflects only yellow light back to my eye.
But there's no dye in a bubble. The bubble liquid is clear.
Good point. Bubble liquid works differently than my shirt, but the color you see still depends upon what travels to your eye. You only see colors when the liquid becomes a bubble. When white light enters a bubble, it bounces around inside the bubble wall, causing the light to separate into its different colors.
But I see the colors swirling and changing.
Yeah, those bubble walls are wobbly. The liquid is moving around in the bubble all the time.
So the colors we see change based on the thickness of the bubble?
Yeah, if the light goes through a thicker part of the bubble, it gives you a different color than a thinner part of the bubble.
Just blow on it and watch the colors change.
This idea of color coming from a material structure is something that happens all the time in nature. Scientists call this structural color.
Like when light passes through raindrops, splitting into a rainbow.
Ooh. Or the tiny structures on this butterfly wing that reflect only the blue.
Ah. But what do scientists do with structural color?
New kinds of paint, tiny sensors. They're working on tons of things.
Here's one. Money. Looks normal, right? Angle it to the light, and you'll see a shift in color. We can print structural color on paper money for security. It makes money really hard to counterfeit.
There's lots of experiments going on now for all kinds of colorfully clever uses.
Cool, so you don't need this bag, right?
Devin!